Welcome to Filmora Pro, a new way to power up your storytelling. In this video, we'll be covering how to adjust the speed of your clips for slow and fast motion, how to create a speed ramp, how to create a freeze frame, and how to reverse your clips. If you're only looking for a specific one of those topics, you can skip ahead to the timestamps in the description. Filmora Pro comes with several ways you can adjust a clip's speed. The fastest way to adjust a clip's speed is with the Rate Stretch tool. You can toggle it by clicking this icon or using the S key. The Rate Stretch tool will stretch or squeeze the length of your clip, meaning that if you make the clip longer, the speed will get slower, and if you make the clip shorter, the speed will get quicker. Let's take a look at that. A more exact way to adjust your clip is by right-clicking the clip and selecting Speed Duration. From there, we can adjust our clip's speed and duration to speed it up or slow it down. Let's set our speed to 40%, and there we go. Now you might notice that this clip looks pretty choppy. Filmora Pro is duplicating some of the frames because there aren't enough in this clip when we slow it down. When getting slow motion for your clips, it's important to understand the relationship between speed and frame rate. When editing slow motion clips, it's important to understand what frame rate your project is and what frame rate your footage that you're working with is. You can see and change your project frame rate by hitting this gear icon in the editor and view your content's frame rate in the media panel. Many video cameras, DSLRs, and even smartphones come with different frame rate options. Usually you can shoot as low as 24 frames per second, and sometimes as high as 120 frames per second, or even higher. High frame rate footage is ideal for slow motion since you can stretch it out and still have a smooth frame rate in your project. Currently, the best way to get smooth-looking slow motion out of your high frame rate videos is to change your clip's frame rate right in the media panel to the frame rate of your project, and to do this all before pulling it into the editor. For example, we've got this project that's 24 frames per second. We've got this one clip that we've shot in 60 frames per second. If we drag it onto our timeline, we'll see it play in regular motion. To change our clip to slow motion, let's hit the gear icon in the top right corner and go to frame rate, uncheck from file, and set it to our edit's frame rate, which is 24. Now when we drag it into the edit, we'll see that the footage plays back in smooth slow motion. If we want to switch from regular speed to slow motion in the middle of our clip, we can take this clip that we've already slowed down in the media panel and cut it where we want the change of our speed to be using the slice tool. Next, let's right-click the first part and increase our speed so that the clip becomes regular motion again. To figure out how much we need to speed it back up, we'll need to do a little math. The amount we need to speed up the footage to get it to play back at regular speed can be found by dividing the original frame rate that the clip was shot at by the frame rate of our edit. Since this clip was 60 frames per second and we slowed it down to 24 frames per second, we'll need to speed it up to 2.5 times that speed, or 250%, to bring it back to original speed. Finally, we'll switch to our selection tool and get rid of this gap between our clips. And there we go. However, if you want a smoother speed ramp, what we can do is go back to our original clip and in the effects panel under temporal, add a speed effect onto it. First, we'll want to speed our clip to regular time, so just like before, 2.5. Next, let's create a keyframe where we want our speed ramp to start. And another keyframe about a second in or so. Let's bring the second keyframe back down to 1, and now the clip will smoothly speed ramp down to slow motion. This can sometimes be processor intensive, but you should get smooth playback once you export your video, so long as your export is the same frame rate as your project. You can reverse your clips with the time reverse effect. If we want to time reverse this clip, we can grab the time reverse effect from the temporal folder onto our clip. Now our clip will play in reverse. There are two ways you can create a freeze frame in Filmora Pro. The first and fastest way is to slice your clip where you want to create your freeze frame with your slice tool, and then drag the speed effect onto the clip on the right. From there, set the speed to 0%. A more flexible way to do this, especially if you want to adjust the freeze frame's length or freeze an image made of multiple layered clips, is to export a frame and bring it back into the edit. To do this, you can hover over the frame you want to freeze, slice your clip under the playhead, or hit Ctrl or Command B to split your clip. Next, without moving the playhead, go to the viewer panel and under Options, click Export Frame. Save it somewhere you won't lose it, import it back into the media panel, and drag it to where the cut in your footage is. You're now free to adjust how long or short you want that freeze frame to be. So that's a quick look at how you can work with speeding up and slowing down your videos, reversing them, and creating freeze frames in Filmora Pro. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on more tutorials on how you can take your editing to the next level. There's no limit to what you can make.